So if you're planning on buying an M2 Pro Mac Mini for video editing, I think there's a few things that you need to take into consideration. And I'll share them with you along with my recommendations right after this intro. What's up guys, it's Ren here with another video, and today I'm gonna tell you why you should buy the Mac Studio instead of buying the M2 Pro Mac Mini. So if you're new here, smash that subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you don't miss my next video. So the M2 Pro Mac Mini is a great machine because I've tested the regular M2 version and the results are great. The results are higher than the previous gen chip, but we know that for video editing, any machine relies heavily on the GPU performance. That is where my recommendation comes in, the base Mac Studio. But wait, you must be saying, Rayon, the M2 Pro Mac Mini is cheaper than the Mac Studio. And you are correct. The M2 Pro Mac Mini is cheaper than the Mac Studio in its regular configuration. But if you spec out the M2 Pro Mac Mini in an attempt to match the base Mac Studio, you'll quickly realize that it's higher in price than the Mac Studio, coming in at $100 more than the Mac Studio, and in some cases $200 more than the Mac Studio. And even at this point, the M2 Pro Mac Mini is still at a disadvantage when it comes to the Mac Studio, because the base Mac Studio has 24 GPU cores, while the M2 Pro Mac Mini has a maximum of 19 GPU cores. And we all know that more GPU cores equate to better performance when it comes to video editing, especially in Final Cut Pro. When I did the benchmark test a couple days ago, the results were quite fascinating, but I figure I would just hold them for this video, because when you take a look at the OpenCL and Metal score, you clearly see that the Mac Studio beats the M2 Mac Mini, especially because it has more GPU cores. And I do understand that I did not test the M2 Pro Mac Mini, but numbers are numbers and numbers don't lie. In addition to the extra GPU cores of the Mac Studio, there's one more thing that you need to take into consideration, and that's the fact that the Mac Studio has 2 video decoding engine and 4 video encoding engine for H.264, HEVC, and ProRes RAW, as well as 4 ProRes encoder and decoder engine. While in the case of the M2 Pro Mac Mini, there is only 1. So that clearly indicates that the Mac Studio is the better machine for video editing. You can even bump up the performance of the Mac Studio by spending a little bit more and getting more GPU cores. And if that's not enough, the Mac Studio gives you 3 additional ports, 2 USB-C and my favorite, the SD card reader, in which the M2 Pro Mac Mini does not provide that. Instead, you'd have to go out and purchase a dock or dongles. And to top it off, they both take up the same footprint on your desk. The Mac Studio is just taller. There's only 4 advantages that the M2 Pro Mac Mini has over the Mac Studio, and that's the HDMI 2.1 port, Wi-Fi 6E for slightly better connectivity, as well as Bluetooth 5.3, and last but not least, 2 extra efficiency core that allows the M2 Pro Mac Mini to get slightly better CPU performance. The memory bandwidth is also better on the Mac Studio at 800 bits per second compared to the 200 bits per second on the M2 Pro Mac Mini. So for video editing, I would recommend buying the M1 Max or M1 Ultra Mac Studio, because you'll definitely get better performance where it matters. I use my base Mac Studio to edit all the videos that you see here on the channel for the past 5 months with no issues, and it does it completely silent. No drop frames, no spinning beach ball, just solid performance. The M2 Pro Mac Mini is better suited for photo editors that work with large files in Affinity Photo, Photoshop, or Lightroom. I will be leaving both links to the Mac Studio and M2 Pro Mac Mini in the description below. So guys, that's it for this video. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it. Thanks for watching, and catch you guys in the next one. Peace.